Hey bud, so like some people said, you can use, there are some plugins, but this is how you can write your own formula to calculate the book IDs, so ISBNs, whatever. So there's a couple things I want to start with. Here's my form responses. I'm adding a column to that form, and I've got a second sheet set up, so we can call these book ID. And this is just some data in here, so this would be your static data. This is not going to be seen by anybody. My form, I've got, here we go. Here's my form, just which book, book one, book two, so these are book titles, whatever. So what we want this to do is we want it to compare this entry with your database and return this number. So here's how you could do it. So we need to use an array formula because I need this to apply the entire way down the sheet. If you just clicked and dragged the box, it would only apply each time you did that, because forms, they add new rows, so they're not it's not filling in empty space, it's adding a new one each time, so you need to apply that formula. But array formula just says anything on this page, do this. So array formula, and then we're going to use vlookup, which takes an input and compares it to something else. So my vlookup, my search key is going to be this entire column. So I'm going to say, starting with b2, the entire column B, so each row will be checked. And then my range, now to get the data from the other spreadsheet, we need to import that range, import range. I copy my URL, and this goes in quotation marks, so quotes. And then my range is going to be this book ID, so we can just copy this and see how it fills in. So book ID A1 to B3 or B5 or whatever, however many books you want. So I'm going to go back here. Close that, because that also needs to be in quotes. So quotes book ID exclamation point A1 to B3. Close that. For the import range, then the index is which column of my range. So if we go back here, I want column number 2 because I want those numbers, and I want an exact match. So we write in true, and then I close. I've got two close quotes because I'm working with two open quotes over here, and hit enter. And you see what it does is it looks through and it loads all this data, and it might take a minute because I've got a big spreadsheet here. But essentially what's going to happen is you're going to see these numbers begin to populate. So there we go. So book one has 100, which is right there. If I add another form response, so I come back here and say it's book two, I hit submit. It submits it, and then it gives it that number. So that's custom how you would do it. As you build in data, you would need to spread out your arrays or whatever you're doing. So I hope this is helpful. Let me know if you have more questions.